The 2009 protests in Iran, also known as the Green Revolution, urged reminiscence to the 2007 Saffron Revolution in Burma. Civilian journalists from Burma and Iran issued pictures, videos, and messages of the demonstrations as thousands of people marched in opposition to their governments. There were more similarities than there were differences in the protests of Burma and Iran. Media technology played a major role in both protests. Both Salar Iruni, an Iranian living in the United States, and Jalin, a Burmese native, say that neither the Iranian nor the Burmese protests were successful.
Burma is still under military dictatorship, and the protests by the monks in 2007, I mean, what came out of that? But more bloodshed and violence.
Did the fighting in the streets really change anything? No, but it showed to the world that the people do care and they're not just sitting back.
However, Gabriel Hopkins, the development coordinator of Digital Democracy, a company that promotes education, communication, and participation through mobile and internet technologies, say that both protests were successful since it reshaped networking and civic participation.
There was some interesting parallels between the protests in Iran and those that happened in Burma in 2007. Primarily, what we were interested in noting was the way that new media, things like Twitter, Facebook, YouTube, and generally mobile phones and internet platforms were being used to organize activism around the protests and then also spread news about the protests. Both around the country and around the world.
The media in both countries became a powerful tool to inform people about the protests. Facebook, Twitter, and blogs were the primary social websites that were utilized to send reports. During the Saffron Revolution in 2007, Burmese bloggers contributed to news gathering and reporting. So how does social networking work using Twitter? I'll show you. It's quite simple. First, you log into the account and you write something personal. What are we doing? And we are reporting for VOA News. You press update, and the news is spread fast. So this is how social networking worked during the protests. Salar Iruni talks about how he used Facebook to connect with other Iranians during the protests.
You know, like everyone else, changed my main picture to a few different images of what was going on there, or like, you know, the peace sign with the green flag saying, where's my vote?
Burma is a totalitarian nation where Iran has some sort of democratic space. Many feel that the Iran revolution was more successful because Iran is a key player in world politics, whereas Burma isolates itself from the world.
They make themselves out there. You know, Ahmadinejad goes to the United Nations and makes a speech calling for the destruction of Israel. Of course people are going to pay attention to that. And Iran is a major, major player in the conflict in Iraq, a major player in the conflict in Afghanistan. I mean, it borders both countries, and they are critical to that part of the world. Whereas Burma, they've been trying to be quiet for a very long time. The generals in Burma would like nothing more than nobody knows where they are. That's exactly what they want.
The protests of Iran and Burma share more similarities than they do differences. The people hold the same ideals for equality and human rights. And the citizens of both Burma and Iran are communicating to the world through the help of simple technology, accessible at their fingertips.
The fact that technology played such a crucial role in that movement really taught the world a lesson. And I'm sure that a lot of the people in Iran, even if they didn't know it specifically, we're learning lots of lessons from the Saffron Revolution.
To get his voice heard, Jalin put up a song he made, Free Burma, on YouTube. For Voice of America, I'm Kaylin. Spiritual demons, political freedom, civil liberty, man, that's what I believe in.